So good morning. So let us start today's class. Now in the last class we have seen what is joint PMF. So let us see functions of multiple random variable. Now here Z is a function of two random variables X and Y. Now so expectation of that function would be summation over XY gxy its PMF. So this is called JPMF. In the shortest form, it is called JPMF, which means joint PMF. That is the short form of joint PMF, that is JPMF. Now, so we are extending this formula. So in the last classes, I told you ax plus b of expectation of ax plus b equal to a into mu x plus b. What is this mu x? That is expectation of x. Now I am writing for two random variables. So what I am writing? Expectation of ax plus by plus c equal to, what do you write now? A into mu x plus b into mu y plus c, where a, b, c are some scalars or some constants. Now, so till now we have seen only two random variables. There could be more than two random variables. For example, let us take there are three random variables x, y, z, and their corresponding joint PMF is defined like this: x equal to x, y equal to y, and z equal to z. So the true meaning is this. Okay, if there are four, what do you write? Suppose p of a, b, c, d of a, b, c, d. Now this is the joint PMF of four random variables a, b, c, d. Now what would be the definition? It would be equal to capital A equal to A, capital B equal to B, capital C equal to C, and capital D equal to D. This would be the definition of the joint PMF if there are four random variables. So in the same fashion, you can write for any number of random variables. Now, so in the last classes, we have seen how to get marginal PMF from joint PMF of two random variables. Now, here we have three random variables. How many? Three. Now, from three random variables, how to get marginal PMF? First, three random variables into two random variables. So, here I am converting what? Three random variables into two random variables. And later I will make two random variables into one random variable. Now, here what we do? We are doing summation over z. I told you also, if you take summation over any variable, that variable will vanish. So here, since we are taking summation over z, z will vanish. Then we are left with x, y. Okay. Now, so we got this. Correct? Now from this, I want to eliminate y. I want to remove y. What do you do? I'll take summation over y. Okay. Otherwise, you can also think of like this. So there are three random variables in this PMF, JPMF. I'm taking summation over y as well as z. What happens? This y and z will go out. You're left with only x. Okay. Suppose if I ask you, what is the PY of y? So I have three random variables, x, y, z. So I want only one random variable, which means I have to eliminate remaining two. What are they? X, z need to be eliminated. How I do with this? You take summation over x and summation over z. So these two will be eliminated. You get py of y. How to get py of z? So we have three random variables x, y, and z. So I want p z of z. So I want to eliminate x as well as y. So what I do? I take summation over x, summation over y. So p x y z of x, y, z. We'll get only one marginal PMF. In this way, you can find out marginal PMF from joint PMF of any number of random variables. If there are four random variables, you should take three summations to eliminate three random variables, so that you will get only one random variable at the end. Now, so this is very, very important. So what are we saying here is expectation of a1x1 plus a2x2 so on anxn equal to a1 into expectation of x1 plus so on like this. X1, x2, xn are some random variables. A1, A2, An are some constant or some scalars. Now this is very, very important. You must know. So what I'm saying is, so that is expectation of some constant A1 into some random variable X1 plus A2, X2, so on, An, Xn will be equal to A1 into mu X1 plus A2 into mu X2 plus so on plus An into mu Xn. So this is called, what is called? Linearity property of the mean. Okay. So it is very, very important. We will solve one problem based on this. Now, so let us proceed further. Now, here, so that is about, yeah, so let us take this problem. So probability has, class has got how many students? 300 students, and each student has a probability of 1 by 3 of getting an A grade independently of another students. What is the mean of X? They are asking what is the expectation of random variable X. But what is X? X equal to number of students who got A grade. So simply they are asking in a class of 300 students. So what is the mean that Number of students getting A grade. How many of them will get A grade? Okay. Now, so here probability of getting A grade is 1 by 3 means not getting A grade is obviously 2 by 3. Okay. Now, so let us proceed with the problem. Now, so we have a class of how many students? 300. Now, so here I will model each and every student as a random variable. So first student, so let us call first student as x1. X1 is a random variable. First student is a random variable. Second student is another random variable. Second student, let us call x2. So like this, we have 300 student, that is x 300. So we have x1, x2, so on, x 300 random variables. Each student is a random variable. Okay. Now, so what kind of random variable is this? We know that each students may get a grade or may not get a grade. Each student may or may not get A grade. So here for X1 we have only two possibilities. What are they? He may get A grade or he may not get A grade. Now what kind of variable is this? This is the Bernoulli random variable, where only there are two possibilities. Anyway, so now random variable, let us take X1, which means I am talking about first student of the class of 300. Now, so since it is a random variable, we have to assign a real number. I will call 1 if A, which means if he gets A grade, 0 otherwise. Otherwise means if you doesn't get A grade. In the same way, how x2 is defined? It is 1 if the second student gets A grade, 0 if he doesn't get A grade. So like this, we can define all 300 random variables. Now let me write for generalized random variable xi. It is 1 if ith student gets A, 0 otherwise. Okay, 0 otherwise. Now, so what is a PMF? Okay, let me write the PMF of x1. Px1 of x. What is that? So what is that? Here, so small x can be 0, 1. Okay, now, so if he gets A grade, we call it as 1. What is the probability of getting A grade? 1 by 3. X equal to 1. So probability of not getting A grade? 2 by 3 if X equal to 0. So this is the PMF of X1 random variable. Now, so the PMF is same for all random variables. Because, now if I write generally, Pxi of X, it is same for each and every student has same probability of getting A grade. So that's why it is will be also equal to 1 by 3 if x equal to 1, 2 by 3 if x equal to 0. Okay. Now this is the PMF of all random variables. Where I varies from where to where? Here I forgot to mention. I varies from 1 to where? 300. Here also I varies from 1 to 300. Okay. Now, see, in the question, they have mentioned random variable x. What is that equal to? Number of students getting an A grade. Simply, they are asking how many students are getting an A grade. So, now, till now we have defined random variables x1, x2, x300. They are Bernoulli random variables. Okay. But what about x? How to get x? Now x is simply sum of all those random variables. In the question they have asked this about x. In the question they have asked what is the mean of this x. Now how come x will be equal to sum of all this? Why? Because suppose first student got A grade. X1 will be equal to how much? 1. Second student also got A grade. X2 will be 1. So if third student got A grade, X3 also equal to 1. X3, suppose let us take third student. He got another grade, not A grade. We call it as 0, let us take. Now if you take all sum of all these, you get how many are getting A grade. Suppose all are getting A grade. What will happen? X1, X2, so on, so X3, and all are equal to 1. If you take 1 plus up to 300, you get 300 students. Okay? That's why, if you take sum of all these random variables, the sum will give you the number of students that are getting A grade. Now, but what we want mean of that random variable X. Now we come, here comes the linearity property of the expectation. So they're asking what is the expectation of X? Okay, now, so simply expectation of x equal to what now? Expectation of x1 plus x2 plus so on x300. Just now I told you it is also same as expectation of x1 plus expectation of x2 plus so on expectation of x300. Now, our aim is to find out the expectation of x1, x2, so on, so on, x300. Okay. But, how to find expectation of x1? Capital X1 is simply summation over x x into px1 of x. Okay, now I have defined px1 of x also. Where we have defined? This is I. Okay, now px1 of x is what? This. It is 1 by 3 if x equal to 1, 2 by 3 if x equal to 0. So can you find out expectation of x1? So what will happen here? If x equal to 1, 1 into 1 by 3. If x equal to 0, 2 by 3. It is obviously 1 by 3. Now, what about expectation of x2? It is also 1 by 3 because everything is same. Isn't it? So expectation of all random variables is same. How much? 1 by 3. Now what will happen finally? So expectation of x equal to, so 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 so on plus 1 by 3. How many times? 300 times. So that is 1 by 3 into 300. That equal to 100. So that would be the mean of random variable x that defines the number of students that get an A grade in the class of 300 students. Okay. Now, now we'll move on to another topic that is called conditioning of a random variable on an event. Okay. So it is similar to the conditional probability. Okay. Let me briefly discuss what is the conditional probability. We have discussed already in the previous classes the concept of conditional probability. Conditional probability. Okay. What do you mean by this? What is the conditional probability means? Probability of A after B or A given B. What do you mean by that? So there are two events A and B. So after knowing that B has occurred, what is the probability that A will occur? Otherwise, having some information about B, we know some partial information about B. So knowing that information, what is the probability that A will occur? So knowing some partial information about event B, now we are asking for to find out the probability that A will occur. Okay. So this is a conditional probability. So what is the formula of this? You know already, probability of intersection B by probability of B. Okay. Now, so suppose, so let us take a simple example to understand the concept of conditional probability. Suppose you take COVID-19 cases. So let us take symptoms of COVID-19. What are the symptoms generally? So the general symptoms are fever, maybe cough, cold, body pains. Let us take. Now, suppose we have there is one person who has got fever. He is suffering from fever. Now, so we have to find out what the probability that he will be a COVID positive given that he has a fever. Okay, now, so what we know about that person? We have some information about that person conditions. What is that? He has got fever. Now, knowing that he has a fever, what is the probability that he will be COVID-19 positive? So this is called conditional probability. Okay, so we can also find out, so in the reverse way, I mean, you can also find out, so what is the probability that he will be a COVID patient given that he got body pains? Okay, now, so what we know about that person is suffering from body pains. Then knowing that, I'm asking what the probability that he will be a COVID positive case. Okay, now these are some examples of conditional probability. Okay, now, now sometimes they may ask you what the probability of getting COVID given that he has got so many symptoms, maybe all symptoms, fever, cold, of body pains, something like that. Okay, so already, so simply what event has already occurred, getting a body pains, suffering from fever, etc., etc. So that has already happened. Knowing that, we are finding the probability that he might be a COVID positive case. Okay. So here we are finding the probability of an event A based on another event B. Okay. Here we are checking for COVID positive based on his symptoms. So these symptoms are already happened, or we have some information about that person. The person may be suffering from all these symptoms or any one of these symptoms. Knowing that, we are finding the probability that he might be having a COVID. Okay. So that is some kind of conditional probability concept. Okay. Now, so we have discussed all these things, but now we are discussing with respect to random variables. So that is a difference. Earlier we have discussed with respect to two events, A and B. Okay. Now here we are discussing conditioning of one is random variable and other is event. There are no two events. One is random variable and one is event. Okay. So I just request you to not to get confused by these notations. They are very, very simple. Just like the conditional probability of two events, which we discussed in the previous classes. Okay. Now, so P of X given A, which means probability that capital X equal to small x given that A. So it is a PMF of conditional PMF. What this is? Conditional PMF. CPMF means conditional PMF. Okay. So the notations may be little bit confusing, but the concept is exactly same. Okay. P of X given A. Clear? So I should write capital X. Sorry. So we'll make a mistake here. Capital X. Okay. Now, so X equal to X given A. Now, what is this? You assume like this. So this is event A. This is an event. Let's assume that it is an event. Some C. So some C. We are asking for P of C given A. So what do you write generally? So probability that X equal to small x intersection A by probability of A. Okay. So there is no need to confuse at all. Is it clear? So remember these formulas. Same thing we will write for the any conditional probability. So this formula is exactly same formula that we are using now itself, and there is no difference. So here, instead of A, we have X equal to small x. That's it. Everything is same. Now, so here A and B are two events, but here we have one event, one random variable. So that is the logic. Okay. So that's why what we have written here. P of X given A. X is a random variable, A is an event. Okay. Now what do you written here? P of event random variable X equal to small x intersection A. That's it. By P of A. So we are using the same formula. There is no difference at all. There could be some confusing with respect to notations, but so I hope you are okay with this. So don't get confused, stick to the original definition. Okay. Now what will happen? Now how to get P of A? Summation over X, Px of X intersection A. Okay. Now this is also very, very important. Clear? So now this is called normalization property. What is called? Normalization. Now, how to prove this? Can you prove this? So let me write summation over x, P of x given A. that equal to summation over x. What is p of x given a? So now what is p of x given a? Have you written here this formula, right? So p of x equal to x intersection a by p of a, right? So you can take p of a outside summation because that is independent of x. Now what will happen here? That equal to summation over x p of x equal to x intersection a by p of a. What is p of a? This is the numerator is p of a. You will get 1. So let us take a simple example of conditioning of a random variable on an event. Please remember. Okay. Now, so let x be the roll of a die and let a be the event that the roll is an even number. One random variable, one event is there. Okay, so let us solve this. So x is the roll of a die and a be the event that the roll is an even number. Okay, x is the roll of a die. Okay, x is the roll of a die, it is 6 ways die. And what is event a? Getting an even number. Event a is getting an even number. What is event a? Getting an even number. So even number. Now what is event a would be? What are elements of event a? 2, 4, 6. Correct? But what about role? X can take from where to where? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the random variable is x. That is outcome of a roll of a die. It could be 6 possibilities. What about event a? They are asking only getting even number, that is 2, 4, 6. First of all, what is the probability of a? What is the probability of a? What is the probability of a? So in a, there are only 3 elements. By the total elements in the sample space, 6. So that is 1 over 2. We got p of a. Now, so let us go to the, yes. Now what is p of x given a would be? What a formula. So p of x given a equal to probability that x equal to small x given roll is even. Okay, this is the event a. Now, so then what do you write? P of x equal to x and x is even given by p of roll is even. Okay, so let me write the conditional probability here. So p of x given a equal to probability that x equal to small x and a given by p of a. So this is the definition of conditional probability, conditional events. In this case, x is a random variable, a is event. Now, so what about small x? It can take 6 values, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Now, so what will happen? Probability that x equal to 1 given a means what? So the probability that x equal to 1 given a, what will happen? Which means we are finding probability that capital X equal to 1 and a given p of a. So whatever numerator would be. So x equal to 1 means outcome of a roll is 1 and a, what is a would be? Even number. Okay, 1 is not even number. So what is the probability of this numerator? 0. Is it okay? So you got 1, but we are asking for even number. 1 is odd number, so of the probability is 0. So what is this answer? So P of x equal to 1 given A is 0. Okay, so let me take P of x equal to 2 given A, which means probability that x equal to 2 and A by P of A. So so x equal to 2 and A, is it okay? So what is A? Even number. Is 2 ever even number? Yes. Okay, getting 2. So what a probability of getting 2? What a probability of getting 2? 1/6. All are equally probable. Okay, by probability of A, we have calculated already. That is 1/2. That equal to how much is this? 1/3. Now, so let me take, obviously, so the probability of getting 4 given A, it is also 1/3 only. Probability of getting 3 given A, why, what is this? 0, because you are getting 3 in a roll of a die, but we are asking for even number. 3 is odd number, obviously it is 0. Okay, that is minimum sense. Now finally, how to write the conditional probability now? How to write this? Now, so let me write Px given A equal to, it is 1/3 if x equal to even number 2, 4, 6, it is 0 otherwise. In this way, we are finding the condition of a random variable from the event. Okay, now here, so it's a different scenario. Conditioning of one random variable on another random variable. Here both are random variables. The difference is, here both are random variables. In the previous case, one was random variable, other one was an event. Now here both are random variables. Okay, x and y. Now how we denote? Probability of x given y. Then what is, how you define? Probability that x equal to x and y equal to y by probability of y. Okay, so I am writing the crude way, but let me take the definition of the condition probability, condition of one random variable on another. Now this is the general notation of PMF. Okay, now this is the final notation. Here x and y are both are random variables. So then what do you write? P of x equal to x, y equal to y by P of y equal to y. Now whatever numerator would be, this is a joint probability or joint PMF. By what is this? This is a marginal PMF. Okay. Now here, so let me write without any confusion. So here we know already. Let us take P of A given B. A and B are two events. Probability of A intersection B by probability of B. That we know. Okay. Now when it comes to two random variables X, Y, let us define joint PMF, conditional PMF, sorry. P of x given y, which means probability of x equal to small x given y equal to small y. Instead of A and B, we have x equal to x, y equal to y. That's it. Nothing more, less, nothing less. So probability of x equal to x and y equal to y by probability of y equal to y. So did I change anything? No. Only there is a difference of notations. Nothing more than that. You assume this is A, this is B. Problem solved. A given B or A given B. This is A, this is B. Problem solved. Now, so this is a PMF, no? So now the numerator is joint PMF. We have discussed already. this is PMF of Y over. So this is joint PMF, this is marginal PMF. Suppose if I do reverse, P of Y given X, P of Y given X, what would you write? What would you write? P of X comma Y of X comma Y given P X of X. As simple as that. Okay, nothing to worry. So I told you so many times, just go with the general notation of conditional probability. So here just we have two random variables, that's it, nothing more than that. Yeah. Now, so from this, what are you going to say? Compare these two. So this you get. Otherwise, so this is the another normalization property. Can you prove this? So x comma y of x comma x given y of x given y, what this formula, substitute here in the summation. Okay, what do you get? Let us see. Okay, you solve this, that is homework for you. Okay, so this is the visualization of conditional PMF. So these are all called conditional PMFs. CPMF or conditional PMF. Now, so this is the joint PMF. What is this? Joint PMF. So these are all three conditional PMFs. Okay, what has happened here? We have X and Y equal to 1, 2, 3. Okay, so what I'm getting is Px given Y of X by 3. X by 3 means Y equal to 3. What does it mean? So conditional probability means generally what you write? P, conditional PMF means X given Y of X given Y. That is what we write. So here X by 3 means small y equal to 3. So small y equal to 3, this line. Okay, so we have taken this here, this bar, this and this, the decreasing order of their heights. Okay, now if I say x by 2, which means y equal to 2, this row. Okay, so increasing order, these three bars are written here. So lastly, y x by 1 means y equal to 1. So in this order, this is how we visualize joint PMF. These are conditional PMFs. Okay, now so when it comes to formulas, nothing to worry, they are just difference in notations, not in the concept. Okay, so I hope you can prove this. Okay, try to prove it. Now how you got this? This, from these two, this is called multiplication rule. So in the conditional probability, what is P of A intersection B? P of A into P of B given A, isn't it? In the same way, so here we have A intersection B, in the same way we have joint PMF. Okay, now here you can also think of like this. So this has something like joint PMF is just like P of A intersection B. So now marginal PMF is just like P of B. Okay, you just try to understand in this way. It is very, very easy. So these are all formulas based on the multiplication rule. Okay, So otherwise you just remember these formulas. I told you already, A intersection B equal to P of A into P of B given A, also equal to P of B into P of what? A given B or A after B. In the same way, these are the two formulas. So to get joint PMF, what are you doing? You are taking marginal PMF into conditional PMF. Okay, so these are the formulas. Is it okay? You take a paper and write all the formulas at one place. You'll get an idea. Just don't simply listen to my classes. Okay, so there is a difference in the notations, not in the concept. Okay, so this is about conditional probability, joint conditional PMF, joint PMF and marginal PMF, just like conditional probability and normal probability. Okay, so we stop here. We'll discuss these things in this class. Thank you.